Hi, I'm Emma, Environmental Specialist at Ecochain, and I'm going to explain how to make a flowchart. So, a flowchart is a very important part of the first phase of your LCA, which is the goal and scope phase. And in your goal and scope phase, you determine what the goal is of your LCA, so what you want to achieve with it, and also what the scope is of your LCA, so how you're going to achieve this goal. The flowchart is actually a very important part of the second thing, so the scope part of your goal and scope phase. So what you do in the scope part is, first off, you decide on a functional unit, which is the unit in which you're going to measure the thing that you're doing your LCA about, for example, a product or service or a certain function. And in this video, I'm going to take the example of one apple pie. So I want to measure the environmental impact of one apple pie. So this is my functional unit. The second thing I need to do in my scope phase is actually assess the system around this apple pie and decide what am I going to include, what am I going to exclude, what is actually all necessary to make this apple pie. This is where the flowchart comes into play, because the flowchart essentially is just a visual representation of this product system that I need to make my apple pie. In the case of the apple pie, the flowchart would show, for example, raw materials like eggs and butter and milk and some apples, for example. Also, it would show some processes, so I need to process these raw materials in some way. I need to, for example, cut the apples. I need to put the batter in a certain bowl and mix it, and I need to bake my pie. My flowchart would show all these processes. And then finally, there's also some waste related to my apple pie, which need to be processed. So there are actually two things important about the flowchart. And the first of these two things is that it needs to show all inputs and outputs related to your product system. So everything I just said, the raw materials, transportation of these raw materials, the processing of these raw materials. And it also needs to show a system boundary. So it needs to show, okay, where does my system end? What do I take into account? And what am I actually excluding? It's also important that that is shown. And a second thing that's really important for a flowchart is that it actually shows how all of these parts of the system, so how all of these inputs and outputs are actually leading to the thing that I'm measuring. So to my functional unit, which is in this case, my apple pie. So the flowchart needs to show the relation between all inputs and outputs, like raw materials, processes, waste, that is necessary to get to my apple pie. So it needs to show which materials are going into which processing step and how these processing steps are following on one another, if there are some transport in between, and also which waste is coming out of which process and how this waste is treated. So essentially, the flowchart is the visual representation of the model, the LCA model, that you're going to build in the software. So in this video, I have explained to you how to make a flowchart and why it is important. If you have any more questions about this topic or some problems in making your flowchart, then get in touch with us or look at our website. And thank you for watching this video.